Night everyone, before you watch the video, I just want to tell you it's pretty bad. I had to use my old camera, so if you just want to look at the finds, then just whiz it through to the end and have a look at the roundup. Okay lads, see you in a bit. Well lads, I'm here today again. I'm using my old camera because my other one is, well, to put it technically, knackered. I've took it back, but they haven't got one in, so I've got to wait for another one to come in. So I don't know how this video is going to turn out, but I suppose it's better than nothing, isn't it? I'm in the small field. The other day I was in that one over the edge, just there, and the first one is further back again. So I've only got a couple of hours, and this is like half the length of the other two fields, so I thought I'll just give it a go in here. It's a smaller field, just have a wander about and see what I find. Alright lads, I'll catch you in a bit if I get anything. Well, first signal lads, it was about, well, 4 or 5 minutes ago I last spoke to you. And it's the first signal, and looking at it, I don't know, just the sixth, I think, from here. Don't know if you can see that, lads. Wonder if I put it on macro, would it make any difference? That made any difference. As I say, this is my old camera, so not brilliant. But if we have a look in here, ooh, let's have a look. Is it just the 6th, I think, that one? Yeah, I think it's just the 6th, mate. I think it's 1937. So I don't know if the macro works on this, so I'm sorry if it doesn't. I've got the sun in my face here now. Right, I'll turn that macro off, see if it's any better. It's a 1937, George the 6th penny, so that's not a bad start, is it? First hole. Alright, catch you in a bit lads. Alright lads, I've just got another signal and I've just pulled then out. I don't know what it is. I mean, it doesn't look that old, but I mean, it could be, but it could also be, I don't know, modern 2p. I'll give it a little clean anyway and see what we get off here. Macro one again, see if it works. I don't think it does though, but I'll just give that a little clean. Just going to walk back to my stool, which is up there. Just have a little brew. And I'll give it a clean up there, and on the next dig, I'll let you know what it was. Okay lads, see you in a bit. Right lads, I was just, oh sorry, that other coin was a modern 2p. And I just got a signal here. It was reading 1640 and then 1540 and maybe 1541 or something like that, so I thought I'll give it a dig. And I've just turned it over and there it is on top. Haven't got a clue. Oh god, it could be a penny. What do you reckon? I don't know lads, I'll have to give that one a clean and let you know on that one, but I don't know, I'll say a penny. Right, catch you in a bit. Right lads, I've cleaned this up a bit and under the little magnifying glass I've got. It's George the Third. I don't know what that is. Would it be a Farden? I'm not sure. But it's definitely George III. And I can just see a 6 at the end. So I'm presuming 1806. Might be 1816, I'm not sure. But that's alright then. Little George III. Farden, I think. As I say, this camera isn't brilliant. When I do the roundup, hopefully I'll have my other camera and might get better close-ups of them. Okay lads, I'll carry on. See you in a bit. Right lads, just add this out. I was reading 14:11, 12:11, 12:12, stuff like that, so I thought I'd better dig it. Try and get out the sun a bit. Don't know exactly what it is. I'll put that macro on again. There you go. Couple of studs at the back. Well, it's only very small. Obviously it's been attached to something, but what? I don't know. So it's something anyway, innit? Catch you in a bit. Right lads, I just had a signal on the ETAC. It was giving me a, you might laugh at this one, it was giving me a 35-33, and I thought, no, it's got to be iron. And but it was such a strong signal, and it was showing even in iron on the display, you know, the VIDs or whatever. But I thought I'll dig it anyway. And this has come up. Right, now it's reading, once it's on top, 12:32, 12:33. So all them 35s and all that have been leaving. Could have been something. So I don't know what it is. It's very, very thin. It could be a button, but I can't see no like shank where a shank's been. So I'll just go and have a sit on the stool and give it a clean up and see what, if we can see anything. Alright lads, see you in a bit. Right lads, I've just been to pick up my camera. I can use it today though, because I think you've got to charge the battery, if I can remember from last time. So I'll have to use this old one, but I'm not going to do any close-ups because the macro doesn't work on it at all. So, but I'll be using this one for the roundup, so I can show you then. But you know, any close-ups and all that. Right, I'm just going up in this field here. Okay lads, I'll catch you in a bit. Right lads, I've just dug this small hole here. I was getting a good signal, 12, I think it was 12:38, and it was jumping to 15:38, and turned it over and I thought it was a coin at first, but I've got a feeling it's going to be a button. So let's get it out. Yeah, it's a button. I'll tell you what though, I've never, I'll hold it further away in case it's blaring, I've never had a button that heavy. Or is it a button? Oh, I don't know. Any ideas, lads? It's got to be a button, isn't it? What is it? I mean, if it's a button, that's some shank. No, I think I'll have to clean that up and then get back to you later. Okay, lads. Catch it in a bit. Right, lads, I just got an iffy signal. Well, not iffy signal. It was bouncing about. It was like 9, 28 and 35 this and 1, 37 and it was just jumping everywhere. Anyway, I just got this out and I can't make my mind up whether it's a coin or a button because it's slightly concave, is it? Is it concave or convex? It's one of them anyway. As I say, I can't show you even a close-up because of this camera, but it's definitely concave or whatever. Can't see no detail on it, so I'll try and give that a clean and see if we can work it out in the roundup what it is. Okay lads, catch you in a bit. Right lads, I've got here a little, well I won't call it a coin ball because it probably isn't, but it's very small, so I'm going for, I'll say little button. You're having a guess? No? Right, I'm on my own then. Little button. But yeah, that's solid. Well, looks like I won that one. Yeah. Trying to get out the sun here, lads. Little button. Oh well, it's exciting when in a coin ball though, isn't it? You know. Right, I'll carry on. Catch you in a bit, lads. Right, lads, we've just had a bomb drop here. I mean, it's left a hell of a crater. I mean, look at this, oh. Look at the size of that. It took me bloody ages. And all it was, after all that hard work, was a buckle. I don't even think it's an old one. It was about, well, what's that? 11 inches, something like that. Why it took me so long, there was iron in here and all, so it was all over the place. But I got the little bugger in the end. Right, catch up in a bit, lads. Right, lads, that's a try and get out the sun a bit if I can. A strange looking thing. Got a hole in the bottom. But I haven't got a clue what that is. Any ideas? Right. So there it is. Let's carry on. Right lads, it's sort of come from over there where that gate is. And I've come across the field. I was going to that edge because there's a footpath runs up this side of the edge, but it's got a cow fence, you know, one of them electric wires, and it was going a bit nuts, so I thought I'll leave it for another day because I think some days he turns them off, you know, in certain fields. Don't know whether that's right, but anyway, I just started walking back. Oh, sorry about this, spinning you around, bet you're going dizzy. And see them two big trees over there? I'm going that way. There's an opening in the edge over there. And hopefully I can nip through, and then I can walk down the road back to that gate I showed you. That's where the car is. Anyway, I just got a little signal there. Well, it wasn't a little signal, it was a good signal actually. and it's a button. I don't think it's a button. Yeah, it is. And it looks to me like it's got a. I say I can't bring it in too close, lads. Otherwise, do your eyes in. But it looks like it's an anchor and a crown above it. So if any of you lads are into buttons and you know your buttons, obviously it's naval, I should imagine. Anyway, I'll carry on over there and see what I get. Okay, lads, catch you later. Right, here we go. This is the roundup from the first half of the video, the first day. No particular order. I don't know what that is. It looks like half a washing, but I think it's old. Button, nothing special. A little, I don't know, is it like a mount or something? Two studs on the back. Could have been broken, I don't know. That 2p, modern 2p. There we go. George the Third penny. I did have the date on it. Was it 1806 or something? Well, that might have been one of the others, but I'm sure it was 1806 anyway. I think that's a George Third Farden. That's gone to nothing. And the George the Sixth penny, 1937, if I remember. Yeah. And it's another farden in it, lads. I cleaned this one up last night, see if I could get it looking any better. I just couldn't see a thing on it, so that hasn't turned out too bad. And I think, is that it, 1806 or 1808, something like that. No, that was yesterday's, lad. Now today's, so no particular order. Piece of shrapnel, I think, I've learnt now. It's what they are. This funny, I think it's a club in it for a leprechaun. Is it? I don't know. I don't know what that is. A buckle that's been battered. A musket ball. That looks like a stud off jeans or something like that. I think probably old, but and this, I thought it was some sort of cup at first when I first pulled it out, and then I think, I don't know, is that a thread on it for screwing in? I don't know. That's, I thought it was part of the rim of a cup or something, but probably not. You see me digging that, if you've watched the video. One massive hole to get that out of, but I don't know, it's an horse bottle, I think, is it? Another little button, you see nine of it, another little button. That thing, I haven't got a clue. Can't be a button, can it? Size of it. There's some weight in it as well, so. Any ideas on that? Looks like it could have snapped off something, maybe, I don't know. Battered owl penny. Couldn't see nothing on it. But I presume it's a George III. As I put it next to that other one, it's exactly the same size, so.
and that button, that you couldn't see that well on the other camera. That's definitely an anchor in it and a crown, so I'll have to have a look. Right lads, so sorry you just rushed through that, but if you watch that video you're probably wishing for it to be over anyway. Oh, hang on, there's the rubbish bits over here, just to show you. I do get the rubbish as well. My last find of the day is this thing. Now what do you say? I think it's an axe head, but I don't think it'll be that old. Although you never know. So any thoughts on that? Just looks like a normal axe head to me, but I haven't got a clue really. Okay lads, I'll see you soon. Hopefully it'll be a better video next time. Cheers lads, take care. Ta-da for now.